I'm Kate Scow, University of California, Davis, and two of my partners are sitting over there, Betty Akalani and Abe Solomon. I wanted to get that in before it all starts to take off. So, innovations in dry season horticulture for women and smallholders in East Africa focused on Uganda, irrigation and soil management is the theme of our project with a very, very strong, big gender lens. Only a few percent of surface area of Ugandan crops are irrigated, and our previous research on leafy greens found way bigger prices in the dry season for vegetables, big market opportunity, and climate change resilient. Rainfall is so unpredictable now, so rain-fed stuff is at risk. Irrigation is really complicated. Biophysically, you have to integrate your ag practices, maintenance and sustainability of it, multiple users and uses of water, environmental consequences. It's also really complicated for social reasons. You need, the markets can change somewhat. Infrastructure needs finance and investment to get it going. Governance, once you put in irrigation, it becomes a lot about that. And land rights, particularly for women, big issue. Farmers are really interested in irrigation, but the support and information around to support it is limited. Solutions are very site specific, so you need participatory processes so farmers design what they need. Project goals are to develop innovation in small scale irrigation using participatory multi-stakeholder platforms, identify constraints and solutions for women, and the third thing is to strengthen that irrigation capacity in Uganda. Let's bring everybody in. Here's where we're working in eastern Uganda. We have There'll be a total of six innovation sites where there's already working farmer groups and access to some degree to markets. And these areas span a variety of different hydrogeologic and climate areas, from not enough water, some of them are pretty arid, to too much water. So it's about managing both situations as well. So a lot of differences among these sites. Wow, I have extra time. Each group has elected a farmer committee, which is central to this project. At least 50% women who interface between the farmer group and technical advisors. There's over 200 farmers reached overall, but this group is really, really important. The elements of the project are first identifying local challenges for irrigation and coming up with some solutions, cultivating women's empowerment, and then coming up with plot level solutions and evaluating those different solutions at individual sites with this focus on irrigation and soil management. We held farmer focus groups, both mixed gender groups and all women groups, to try to understand what some of the issues are that expected outcomes. These were things that were identified in these groups: operations, enabling environment, and working conditions. That can't go through all of these individually, but a lot of different things that had a lot of breadth were identified in these focus groups. And you can map out these things like this, absolutely insane spaghetti monsters, right, of all these different factors and how they're interrelated to one another, but obviously you can't use that. So one of our outputs of our project is this user-designed decision tree for both farmers, but probably a lot for trainers. So you want to irrigate, here is some of the things that you might consider. That is boiling it down from all that complex stuff. Every farmer, every innovation site has a dedicated space where farmers can work on what they chose as the technologies they were interested in. They use participatory design to identify what they wanted to look at, with technical experts coming and interacting with them about what they want to try at their particular site. And you can see them doing there, and I have this extra minute. Okay, and then here's a design, just so you know that we really do stuff. So here's a design at one irrigation scheme at one site that has, depending on the needs, you know, because it's based on what were the needs at that particular site and the concerns of those farmers. And this has a combination of drip and sprinkler. So this is it realized in real life, that design is now implemented here at this site. And so there's comparisons done of the innovation and the former way. And early results are, there's a whole bunch of things, but land access is a huge issue, duh. A lot of challenges with women who rent land, have the possibility to be evicted. Once land is improved in its quality, because there's irrigation support there, then the rent goes up. And scaling out, lots of cool stuff is happening. We had a field day with the district office, and they're expanding one of our sites because they want to use it as a demonstration site. NGOs like ActionAid is interested in adopting some of our approaches. We're collaborating with Texas A&M Innovation Lab, small scale irrigation, using their decision support tools. And it can be used to help scale out to other places. And identifying satellite sites, small sites that gather around the big sites. Here's all our partners. I'm cheating. This is the 21st slide. So I'm cheating. Anyway, we work with a couple of NGOs and with different Ugandan institutions. That's it.